Our today's topic is LR parser. Abstract. LR parsing is one type of bottom-up parsing. It is used to parse the large class of grammars. In the LR parsing, L stands for left to right scanning and R stands for constructing the rightmost derivation in reverse, and K is the number of input symbol of the look ahead used to make number of parsing decision. LR parsing is divided into four parts: LR0 parsing, SLR parsing, CLR parsing, and LALR parsing. Types of LR parser. Here are the types of LR parser: LR0, SLR1, LALR1, and CLR1. Background. Bottom-up parser. Since it's a part of bottom-up parser or shift-reduce parser, build the parse tree from leaf to root. Bottom-up parsing can be defined as an attempt to reduce the input string W to the start of symbol of grammar by tracing out the rightmost derivation of W in reverse. Let's see an example. Here we have input A, B, B, C, D, E, and S produces small a, capital B, small e. A produces capital A, small b, small c, and B. B produces small d. Here, let's take a view in the example. First of all, in second step, the small b is produced by A, capital A. And in third step, the small b is already produced by capital A in the second step, and the remaining small b, small c is produced by another capital A. In the fourth stage, the small d is produced by capital B. Then small b are already produced by A, and small d is already produced by B, and the remaining small a, small b is produced by S. Therefore, S produces small a, capital B, small e, small, then it produces small a, small d, small e, then it produces small a, small b, small c, small d, and small e, and then it produces A, B, B, C, D, E. Here is the classification of bottom-up parser. Bottom-up parser, then LR parser, then LR0, SLR1, simple LR, LALR, look ahead LR, and CLR. Introduction. A general shift reduced parsing is LR parsing. The L stands for scanning the input from left to right, and R stands for constructing a rightmost derivation in reverse. Benefits of LR parsing. Many programming languages using some variation of an LR parser. It should be noticed that C++ and Perl are exception to it. LR parser can be implemented very efficiently. Of all the parsers that scan their symbol from left to right, LR parser detects syntactic error as soon as possible. Next slide will be presented by Mohammad Sibgar Raziz.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is
Mohsen.
And our next slide is LR0 parser. We need two functions, closure and goto function. Second is augmented grammar. If G is a grammar with start symbol S, then G dash, the augmented grammar for G is the grammar with new start symbol S dash, and a production S dash produce S. The purpose of this new starting production is to indicate to the parser when it should stop parsing and announce acceptance of input. Let a grammar be S produce AA. Capital A produce small a, capital A, or small b. The augmented grammar for the above grammar will be S dash produce S, S produce capital A, capital A, A produce small a, capital A, or B. Second is LR0 items. एन एल आर जीरो इज द आइटम ऑफ अ ग्रामर जी इज ए प्रोडक्शन ऑफ जी विथ अ डॉट एट सम पोजिशन इन द राइट साइड एस प्रोड्यूस ए बी सी इल्स फोर आइटम फर्स्ट एस प्रोड्यूस डॉट ए बी सी एस प्रोड्यूस ए डॉट बी सी एस प्रोड्यूस ए बी डॉट सी एस प्रोड्यूस ए बी सी द प्रोडक्शन ए प्रोड्यूस एप्सिलॉन जनरेट्स वन आइटम्स ए प्रोड्यूस डॉट एप्सिलॉन शिवगत
गुड आफ्टरनून सर, दिस इज मोहम्मद शिवगत अजीज सर. क्लोजर ऑपरेशन एक्सपेंशन ऑफ अ नॉन टर्मिनल आइटम विद अ डॉट एट द एक्सट्रीम लेफ्ट इज कॉल्ड अ क्लोजर. वी कंप्यूट क्लोजर व्हेनेवर देयर इज अ डॉट टू द इमीडिएट लेफ्ट ऑफ अ नॉन टर्मिनल एंड द एक्सपेंडेड येट. सर एक्चुअली हियर वी हैव एन एग्जांपल विद एन ऑगमेंटेड ग्रामर एस दैट प्रोड्यूसेस एस एंड एस इन रिटर्न प्रोड्यूसेस डबल कैपिटल ए and A produces small a and B. So sir, to apply only the closure also, we can say S dash produces S the S and in return sir as a and in return S produces in a capital A as it has a dot in front of it. And in the next step, if there is a capital A which has in front of a dot, and A is also a non-terminal. So we have to also apply a closure over A. And after applying a closure over A, we get a small a which is in a terminal, and a small b after the dot which is also a terminal. So we don't need to expand any further. For after the expansion, if we have shifted on a dot after A, we have another capital A. So capital A is in a non-terminal. So we have to again have a closure operation over it. And after applying the closure operation over it, we again have a small A after the dot and a small B, which are the terminals. So we don't have to do another closure operation over them. The next step after shifting the dot. After a small a, we are now again have a capital A. So we repeat the process in this step two. Anika, next step, next slide. Go to operation is the method in which we shift the dot to the next element, and we check that whether it is a terminal or non-terminal. We can explain this via an example. As we have seen the earlier example, S dot equals to S dash produces an S and S produces a double capital A. And when returns capital A produces a small a capital A and B. So if you produce a go to operation over them, we have we'll shift our dot from one element, and after that we check. We can apply a closure over it or not. So S it has is at initially having a dot at S before. So after the we apply the closure operation, S that comes at the end, and there is no terminal or anything. That means S has been accepted. So we go to the next next line. Where we have a dot of Aniket.
Yes. This slide. Previous. This slide.
Previous one. So after S, we have a dot A. So we will we can apply closure operation. Closure operation as A is a non-terminal. So we again apply a closure operation and we get an dot A dash dot A small a capital A or dot capital B. So here we have another go to operation we can apply. S produces a dot A over A. So after we shift a dot from a capital A to to the right side, we get another A, and we can again apply a closure operation over it. Well, we are again applying a closure operation, and we again get in a small a capital A or a small dot or a small b. So over here we cannot apply any more closure operations. The next thing is a produces in a small a and a capital A, in which if we apply now apply go to operation, the dot will go to the next element which is in a capital A, which is a non-terminal. So we have to apply a closer operation over it. After applying the closer operation over it, we will get in a smaller a capital A slash smaller dot small b. Thank you. Next slide. Construction of a go-to graph. We construct a state, let's say namely I naught. Using I naught and with the help of a DFA, we find the collection of a set of LR0 items. Then we convert the item to LR0 parsing table. The action function takes as an argument a state I and the terminal dollar the input end maker. The value of action IA can have one of the four forms. Shift J, where J is the state, reduce A to beta, accept error. We extend the goto function defined on the set of items to state if goto IA equals to I. Then goto also maps a state I and a non-terminal A to J. The next slide will be presented by Aditya.
Thank you, Sivgat. Myself, Aditya sir, good evening. Here in the 14th slide, we are going to see an example that how LR parser works. So there is a given example that consider the grammar S produces double A and A produces small a, capital A and B also. Now we are going to change into the augmented grammar forms. So we are using here S just produces S and S produces double A and after again A produces small a and capital A and B. The LR0 parsing tables go to graph will be now in the next slide, in the 15th slide. There is a graph. Now there is a DFA graph constructed by the LR0 items, moving by LR0 items. Here in the I0, we see that augmented grammar S that produces dot S and S produces dot A and A. And A produces dot small a and capital A and also dot B. So in this DFA diagram, we see that getting at some input, we are reaching the another state, like at I0 to be going at I1 and I0 to I4 and I3, all those dots are given there. Now let's go in the next slide and see the how the we construct a parsing table using this DFA diagrams. So we can see here these are the total six states we see on the previous slides, that there are six stages, 0 to 6, it is total 7 stages. So here is a parsing table constructed by previous graph. This part is a two part, has a go to and action part. We place non-terminals in go to part and terminals in action part. And those six stages are here, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So we can say that at 0 stage, at input A, it's going on S3. S3 is a shift part. We can say that where it is two types of part here, that one is shift and second one is reduction part. So in the place of shift part, we just say S3. And at the place of reduction part, we place R3. And in the non-terminal part, we just put the number. So in the go-to part, we can see that at I0 stage, getting an input 1, we go for the S state. So after that we can see there are also three reduction part also, R1, R2 and R3. Those are on the 4th, 5th and 6th stages. Now let's move on the next slide. So these are the just notes about the LR parsers we just previously see. These are the note. First note is to reduce production in one state is RR conflict. So in Aniket, can you please show the previous slide again? Yes. So we can see here at R4 there is at A in you can here is a one reduction part is happening R3. So here we can say that if R3 except R3, if any one reduction part is also there, like there is R2 is also giving the same reduction at the same time. So we can say here that RR conflict is happening. Or we can also say that if and the shift part, if we get any reduction in the same cell, so we can say it is an SR conflict. So okay, you can move on, Aniket, next slide 17. So now here is a conclusion one. If no SR or RR conflict present in the parsing table, then the grammar is LR0 grammar. In the above grammar, no conflict. So it is LR0 grammar. So now after me, Aniket.
Thank you. Now let's see some gate level question. Question number one. Consider the following grammar. S produces A, S, B or D. B produces small b. The number of reduction step taken by a bottom up parser while accepting the string AAA D BBB is. What's the answer? The answer is 7. Let's see this explanation. According to bottom up or shift reduce parser, initially AAA D BBB. Then S produces small d, capital B produces small b, S produces A, S and capital B, B produces small b, S produces A, S and capital B, B produces small b and hence S produces A, S, B. Question number 2. Which one of the following kind of derivation is used by LR parser? Leftmost, leftmost in reverse, rightmost, rightmost in reverse. Answer is number D. That is rightmost in reverse. Explanation. An LR parser is bottom up parser. That is why it uses rightmost derivation in reverse. Question number 3. Which one of the following is a top down parser? Recursive descent parser, operator precedence parser, and LRK parser, and LALRK parser. Answer is A. And the explanation is recursive descent parsing is LL1 parsing, which is top down parsing. Next slide will be presented by Aditya.
Thank you, Aniket. In my question, there is consider the following grammar. They are given the production sum. And in the question part, next it is written that consider the following LR0 items corresponding to the grammar above. And these are the given productions here. S produces S star dot E. And E produces F dot plus E. And E produces F dot F plus dot E. Okay. So, given the items above, which two of them will appear the same set in the canonical set of the items for the grammar. So now move for the explanation part. There are some given options also. Let's see first explanation. So here in the explanation part, first let's make the LR0 set of items for the previous given grammar. First, we need to augmented grammar. So for the augmented grammar, we have to add one production part also, that s dash produces dot s. Then we need to find the closure of all the set of items. And now we see the all the set of items for the closure part. So move on the next NK. So here now we can see that there are the all productions are given there and with their corresponding moving go to parts. So in the first I0 stage, we can see that all the starting part is given there. So we can see there that for I0 to I1, we can go at getting at S input and at moving at S. And in the I0 to I2, we go for when we come to, when we go I0 to E, then we get I2. Now in the all the given part are there, but the most important thing is here that we have to see that which two of them, those who given in the questions, are come at the same part. So can you please show me the previous slide, any case, the question part. Yes. So here the part was S produces S star dot E and E produces F dot plus E. So and third one is F plus dot E. Okay, so go on the question slide. But in this part, we can't see any two of the given part is coming at the same set. You can see that one part is coming at I3 part and one part is coming at I4 and one is I5. So we can't say that these all threes are coming at the some common part. So we can conclude that in the LR0 set of items from so far, we can't see the given three items belong to the same set because they all belong to the different set same. Okay, so move on the next slide.
Previous slide.
Next. Okay, huh. So last and question one. Go for the question one. So we consider here the option D is correct because none of the above is coming at the same. Okay, thank you. So next. Next, Aniket, go.
Sibgat, can you?
My question is, which of the following statement is false? An ambiguous grammar has a same leftmost and rightmost derivation. An LL1 parser is a top-down parser. LALR is powerful than SLR. An ambiguous grammar can never be LRK for any K. The answer will be option A. Option A, an ambiguous grammar has leftmost and rightmost derivation. Because to be an ambiguous grammar, it can only have the leftmost or the rightmost. So we see the explanation over here. A grammar is an ambiguous if there exists a string S such that the grammar has more than one leftmost derivation for S. We could also come up with more than one rightmost derivation for a string to prove the above proposition, but not both of right and leftmost. An ambiguous grammar can have different rightmost and leftmost derivation.
So our next slide is conclusion. LR parser can handle a large class of context-free grammar. The LR parsing method is the most general non-backtracking shift-reduced parsing method. An LR parser can detect the syntax error as soon as they can occur. Second point is LR grammars describe more language than LL grammars. An LR0 item is the production G with dot at some positions on the right side of the production. And first point is LR0 item is used to indicate that how much of the input has been scanned up to a given point in the process of parsing.
Very good presentation. Thank you all. Only thing I want to mention is that at the shift reduce and then the LR0 comes when the input first thing is input terminals can go and there is a state stop of the stack, it will be state number. There will be always a pairs. They always moved in pairs whenever they push the terminals and variable. When the variable can be, when there is the reduce action. When there is a reduce by any rules, a reduce rule by 2 or 3, the left hand side of that variable will come. And what the state number? State number should consult from the parsing table. From the somebody has mentioned it correctly, but it should be go to section only for the variable. Whenever you are reducing to the left hand side of a rule to a particular variable, it cannot be the first stage, definitely first stage, then that corresponding the variable and to the you get the state number. So again, the state number will be always there. So your top of the stack will be hellos at the state number. So shift reduce, if you have mentioned, that is great. The why the reduce number, whenever they reduce, all the rows follow the same. That is, whenever you go for LR1, it will be only one entry probably. See, even when you reduce one, see all are R1 rows particularly. If you just look at it, that is a good one. You have covered LR01, fantastic. Whenever LRK, whenever you see the one look ahead only, K means K look ahead, but that is a lot of entries. If you take one look ahead, LR1, that is immensely powerful than LR0. LR0 is hardly more powerful than LL0, even less powerful than LL1, but LR1 is LR0 is less powerful than LR1 definitely, and is hardly more powerful than LL0, but LL1 is much powerful, LR1. So LR1 is much powerful. So that is with one look ahead, but the tables entries are much more, so we have to combine some table entries. We go for look ahead LLR, and more simpler and between LR0, but definitely better than LR0 is simple LR. That's great. And but one thing might now come to a general question for you all, that why your compiler is more and more important, because day by day CPU is changing. The CPU is coming right now with GPUs and graphical process unit. Your motherboard can contain 8 CPUs, sometimes maybe 100 CPUs are already. Then your language also changing, your language is coming Python and all these things. So you have always require a compiler, good compiler interpreter, so that the language and mapping between language, evolving language like Python or Kotlin, and evolving hardware and compiler interpreter. So compiler study is be always there, is the heart of the computer science after the data structure and automata. And the compiler will be always there, and natural language processing, the same things the compiler is there. This is for all. It's excellent.